The app that I get the most requests from you guys to cover is Notion.
Tutorial básico para que aprendan a utilizar Notion.
أقوى أداة أنا استخدمتها لحد دلوقتي وهي
Notion.
ये को इतना सारा प्यार दिया. अगर आप नए हैं तो Notion एक बहुत ही amazing note taking app.
Pink shirt today because why not? If you've been to these YouTube streets, you've probably had a certain word mentioned, Notion. Yours truly has also done a video about Notion. It was really one of the videos that got 1,000 views on this channel, and that's not a joke. When you're just starting out on YouTube, start. You guys start and you'll understand what I'm talking about. Anyway, today felt like I should revisit Notion. You guys have heard a lot about Notion, and some of you might have already jumped onto the bandwagon and are using Notion. Really, I can't overstate the fact that Notion is a very nice app. But the truth is, after about a year or so of using Notion, I found that there are points at which, especially earlier on, Notion really took up quite a lot of my time, time that I would probably have channeled into something more productive. And I know that some of you who might be starting out on Notion, especially students, those of you with personal projects and so on, might find that Notion is actually time consuming, and you might end up losing the valuable time that in the first place you installed Notion to make the most of. So how do you avoid wasting your time on Notion? Let's get started. The very first thing you should keep at the back of your mind is that Notion is not a Swiss Army knife. So in as much as Notion is designed to do a wide range of productivity tasks for individuals and for teams, you need to know that Notion cannot do everything. You shouldn't use Notion for everything. Let me give you an example. You may have just downloaded Notion and you're very excited. You started downloading and installing all these templates for your business or for your personal work, be it reminders, to-do lists, Kanban boards, all this stuff that you might want to do. If you're like me, a lot of times that excitement might make you want to migrate all your stuff from every other app that you're using into Notion. An example is your calendar that might be on Google Calendar and your notes on Google Docs or Evernote or somewhere else. If you're a writer, you probably have long form articles on another app. And there's this drive to want to migrate everything into Notion, and that's the first mistake you'll make. My personal advice is that if you get into Notion, just use Notion for one particular project. In my case, as an example, I use Notion only for managing this YouTube channel and nothing else. In charge for taking notes, for example, I use Samsung Notes because I'm used to it. The pen support makes it easier, better, much nicer to use. The same goes for school. I rarely actually write any medical notes of late, but if I was to write any notes, I'd probably use Samsung Notes. Keep Notes is another neat little app I use, and I find it very nice for quick notes anytime I'd like to jot down something short, something quick, a shopping list or any ideas really that just come flashing by. I'd much rather launch Keep Notes because it's quick, it's faster than Notion. In a matter of seconds, I'm up and running and I'm putting down whatever I wanted to put down and I'm done. So really, if you want to use a calendar, just use your calendar app that you're used to. If you're gonna make a presentation, PowerPoint is there for you. It's tried and tested over the years. It will probably be a much easier experience than trying to make a presentation on Notion. Oh yeah, Notion can do that, but you're much better off saving your time. Just jump into PowerPoint and make your presentation, or Keynote if you're on Mac. The point here is, when there's an app that you're used to that does what you want to do at the moment, you don't really need to struggle to do it on Notion. Notion is awesome, but let it do what it does best. You don't have to struggle to do everything on Notion just because it's nice. Let not these apps, be it Notion or anything else, make you stop using your brain. And an example is, you come across someone who is using Notion for study, and you'll find them listing all the topics and making a whole lot of notes that really at some point it's just as good as a textbook. There's a point at which I believe it's literally just time wasting. I think among the worst study practices that I see out there is guys like writing so much notes. Why don't you just read the textbook? Why would you transfer all that body of knowledge and make so much notes on Notion? It would make more sense to me to probably have a bunch of checkboxes which you could check out once you're done studying some topic and so on. Then there's this other group of people who really have their whole life happening on Notion. In as much as there's to-do lists and so on, you don't have to write everything down. If you're going to meet the president of your country at 3 p.m. for example, do you really need to launch an app and enter that somewhere, you know, meet the president at 3? You want to tell us that you'd forget that? There's stuff that you can't really forget. So where your brain cells can work, use them. You don't have to use apps for everything. In the past 2 weeks, as an example, I had 4 exams, 3 written papers and 1 clinical exam, and These are really exams that are important. I've spent quite a lot of time studying for them. I don't see why I'd like launch a calendar app just to, you know, write there that I have an exam on this date. I have an exam on this date. I can't forget that I have an exam. Anyway, I bet you get my point. Where your brain can work, don't use any app, right? That's why if you're finding value in this video, I'd appreciate a sub. Thank you. So this is not to throw shade at Notion or make you imagine that I have any issue with Notion. I personally appreciate the kind of work the developers of Notion have put into it. It's probably one of the best productivity apps out there. And really, another way that I think you could save a lot of time on Notion is actually by using Notion's features themselves. Let me give you a few that I think are interesting that have come out in the past few months and I think would save some of you guys quite a lot of time. And the first is synced blocks. And what that does simply is if you have a piece of information that might recur on various pages on your Notion workspace, an example is an address, or let's say you're using Notion for business and say it's a school, you have a mission statement that you'd like to appear on all your pages. What you can do is have that on a block and you can sync that block on various pages. And so if you make an update to that piece of information on one place, it updates all the synced blocks. And for sure that will help you save much more time than if you'd go to each individual piece of information to update it if you change something somewhere. So another nice feature that has come out seeing as Notion of late is quite integrated with other platforms is for those of you who use IFT, if this then that, you can actually have recipes on IFT that if this happens somewhere, let this happen on Notion. An example is if you'd like, say, a list of emails from a certain sender on a page on Notion, you could use an IFT recipe that if I receive this kind of email, let it be listed on this page on Notion. And that would save you much more time than if you opened your inbox on one window and opened Notion on another and kept on checking the inbox and typing out on Notion. You see, those are the kind of tasks that I think you should use apps for to make your work easier, not to complicate your life. The third new feature that has come out of Notion of late is the widgets. And I believe that could actually be a nice time-saving strategy. If you had a page on Notion that you visit more frequently or a page that you'd like to update frequently, you could actually have it as a widget on your phone home screen so that just one click and you're good to go. So when all is said and done, the point I'd like to underline is actually start doing stuff. I think my biggest issue with productivity apps, strategies, and so on is not actually getting you to do your stuff. It's much better not to use any app or watch any videos and so on, but actually do your stuff. And this has actually affected even I personally. There's this time, so instead of just coming in and making a video, I'd watch several videos on YouTube for hours on end trying to find out how would I make my audio better. How would I make my video better? What settings do I need to use? How far do I place my microphone from the corner of my mouth? And all these things, you'd spend so much time watching videos, reading articles and so on, instead of actually just doing your stuff. And it happened to me when I was starting out on Notion. You'd spend so much time to create all these pages and templates and so on, to just make a small list. Just open a page and write your list. You shouldn't really waste a lot of time downloading all these templates and making your Notion workbook look like someone else's. Just do what you need to do. If you're a student, it would be tragic if you spent 3 days setting up your Notion instead of actually reading. So I think the worst enemy of actually getting things done is the preparation to do them. Just make sure you don't waste too much time getting ready to do stuff, downloading apps to organize stuff and so on, that at the end of the day you're even too tired to do actually what you set out to do. And really believe the biggest favor you can do yourself in as far as getting productive is concerned is to really stop this video and the rest of the productivity videos you've watched so far and get your stuff done. So guys, I'd really like to know how many of you use Notion or any other productivity apps to get organized. Comment down below, and if you like this video, like this video. Thank you. See you in the next one, and as always, no pressure.